California Fever.
Disgraceful! Somebody ought to speak to her. What's her phone number?
Hey, she's listed in the yellow pages under educational toys. Come on, I'm late.
You know you're not allowed to drive on the beach.
Look, officer, I didn't want to, but they threatened to kill me if I didn't.
Oh, that's very funny. Let me see a driver. You got a driver's license? Let me see it.
Yeah. Hey, I gotta go, Ross. Come on, officer, give him a break. He just got out of reform school.
Thanks a lot, Vince.
You mean you don't know that unauthorized vehicles are not allowed to drive on the beach? Huh?
On the beach? What are you... On the beach? I'm on the beach. I must have dozed off or something.
Chocolate shake.
Hey, you sure you don't want your alfalfa salad and a protein drink, Vince?
Oh, yeah. Hey, give me a holler if that policeman comes in here.
Right on.
Thanks. Clear as a bell. Yes, it's me, the voice of the underground radio. Well, for all you beach folk out there who's been wondering what's been cooking here on the most humongous 3-watt radio station on the coast, well, let me tell you, it's a new album by the one and only Rex Smith.
Rex Smith? I go bananas over Rex Smith, don't you?
Rex Smith? Do you ever sing with Lawrence Welk?
Not lately.
Well, before I cue it up, here's a little conversation I had with my pal, Rex.
Oh, listen, listen. Vince is gonna play that gag tape you made.
You mean the one he spliced together from Rex's album?
Yeah.
Rex, old buddy, as you know, my listeners are your people.
I don't know.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. While you're in town on your recording date, what do you figure the chances are you boogieing on down to my station to meet all your fans? Really, Rex, that'd be sensational, but I'm a busy guy. Could you give me a definite date?
You heard that? The ghost is gonna get us, Rex Smith, right on the
Rex Smith, here in my place?
I'm not leaving till I see him.
Is that a station on the level, or is that one of those underground stations?
Oh, I tell you, I'd say if it's an underground station, it's definitely not on the level. Because, like, you figure like, levels here, right? And underground's about right here. So you figure if it's underground, it's definitely not on the level. Oh, come on, sir. It's a smile against the law.
No, it isn't. So go ahead and smile.
Well, Rex, everyone in Sunset Beach is going to be looking for an exclusive in-person presence. I hope you dug my little put on.
Ah!
What happened?
Sounds like the ghost just gave up the ghost.
About that interview with Rex Smith coming here live? Well, don't I wish. Well, it ain't about to happen, but we do have Rex on microgroove.
What happened?
As a matter of fact, it's his new album, Rex Smith.
I'm off the air.
Oh. Well, was momentarily among the missing there, but we're back on the air. Yeah, live, coming at you with some more music.
Do you realize that Rex Smith is gonna be right here broadcasting from your place tomorrow?
I guess you're right. But Vince said it.
You ought to put up a plaque.
A plaque? This place would be a shrine. Hey, Tony Fantasio.
Rex Smith, that's so gnarly.
Hey, how'd you do it, kid?
Oh, the tape? Well, I put Rex's stuff on one track, and then I put mine on the other.
Forget all that. What time is he gonna be here tomorrow?
Who?
Rex! Rex Smith!
Rex Smith!
Hey, wait a minute.
I've gotta get his autograph.
Man, what this is gonna do for my place.
Yeah!
I'll take out an ad. Boom! Yeah. Put up a big sign.
Yeah.
Big sign?
I'll create a new dish.
Yeah.
The Rex Smith Carrot Cocktail!
That's right.
The whole beach has gone crazy. Everybody thinks Rex Smith's gonna be here tomorrow.
You better get back on the air and explain Rex isn't gonna be here.
Yeah, and tell him you're on your way to South America, too.
Yeah, thanks. I mean, even Rick believes that he's ordered more food,
Vic!
More drinks. I mean, I gotta put this
thing
together.
Watch it.
Have Rex autograph this. Oh, please, please, please. I'm bringing the whole fan club down to the beach to see him. And Vince, I'll always be grateful.
Are you all right?
Man, she's crazy.
Well, what am I gonna do?
Hey, watch me sign out.
Well, that's the last time I'll ever make a phony interview, I'll tell you that.
Wait!
What?
Send it to Rex. I bet he digs it and will come out to be interviewed.
I don't want to hear these dumb ideas.
Yeah, that's a great idea. Stand at the Park Regency.
Hey, man, how'd you know that?
I read it in a fan mag.
Do it, Vince. Man, the spot you're in, what have you got to lose?
Yeah, besides your life. Oh, come on. It's pretty funny.
Love it. It's Rex Smith's brand new album presented to me by, oh, no, not Rex Smith, but the next best thing, his manager. Hyena Reno is introducing Mel, next best thing.
Glad to be here, Harry.
Glad to have you here, Mel. Of course, we'll be even gladder when you get old Rex down here for a personal and exclusive interview.
Well, we'll talk about...
Music time. Hyena Man's got the smarts. It's number 5 on the charts. Sounds.
Sounds. What sounds?
Now, look. You gotta deliver. My ratings are going down the El Tubo. Mm. I'm losing sponsors. Now the station manager wants my head. I gotta have that interview.
Maybe we can arrange some kind of phone thing. I think that would be nice.
No. No phone. I gotta have him here in person. I tell you, Mel, please, on bended knee, I've got to have this interview.
Oh, hiya, Mr. Goldman. Hi.
This is Mel Gaines. I'm just arranging a very exclusive interview with Rex Smith.
Good. Do that.
Oh, yes, great king of programming.
And don't do that.
Then stop it. Stop looking so gloomy.
Okay.
You can still hear from Rex.
You know, I'm running out of time, buddy.
Hey, what are you talking about? You have hours.
Hey, Ross, your junk burger's ready.
All right, it's about time.
How about a yogurt shake, man? What about a yogurt shake?
Hey, Rick, do me a favor. Keep your health to yourself, okay?
Here, open this up.
Yeah, the FCC is gonna love it.
No. Oh, well. Grab that, will you, Ross?
Rick's place, all good tables are taken. What can I do for you? Who? Rex Smith?
Vince, it's Rex.
For real, it is.
Yeah, it is, man.
It's Rex Smith.
It is.
Is that you, stupid Al? Well, listen, knock it off, because I'm not amused.
Wait,
Vince! No kidding. It's Rex Smith.
Hello?
Hey, Vince. This is Rex Smith. Hey, man. That tape you made just blew me away.
Hey, that's great, Rex. Hey, Rex, you are going to make it here, aren't you?
You tell him all food's on the house. Right, Rick?
Sure. Well, my schedule's pretty tight. I got a recording session tomorrow, and I got to split right away for a concert in Seattle.
Rex, if you could just squeeze it in, you don't know how much it's gonna mean to me and my station.
Yeah.
I only need you for a couple minutes. I mean, if you could find your way down here, well, at your convenience, anytime, it doesn't matter.
Hey, I tell you what, I got a couple hours tomorrow afternoon before my plane, okay?
Hey, you got yourself a deal.
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow at Rick's place at 4, right?
All right, catch you later.
All right! Somebody up there loves you, pal.
Woo! What's going on, Rex?
Hey, you remember that tape I played for you this morning?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I was just talking to the kid who made it.
Oh, you gonna have an interview with him?
Yeah, he's got this little 3-watt underground station on Sunset Beach. I thought I might cruise down.
Uh-huh, 3 watts. I know vacuum cleaners that carry a stronger signal. We can't waste our time with that. Forget it.
Hey, look, Mal. This Vince, what's-his-name, put a lot of work and effort into this tape. I think it's the least I can do to show my appreciation for it.
You're right. Why don't we send over a nice 8x10 glossy autograph?
Look, ordinarily, I let you take care of this personal appearance stuff.
Yeah, and I usually do a good job, so why don't you just let me continue?
What can I say? The kid got to me. I mean, he sounded so happy and excited when I said I'd do it. Hey, it's only half an hour out of my life on Saturday afternoon.
Uh-huh. At 4. Yeah. Exactly when I've booked you for K Groove.
Oh, no, Mel. Not the Hairy Hyena show. Oh, come on, that turkey was out of it 10 years ago.
Yeah, but he's making a comeback. No problem.
Hey, look, you just gotta cancel it. I can't let those kids down.
No, 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 don't let it happen, Mel. You gonna let Rex pass me up for some little cockamamie free water? Look, I got a lot right on this interview. I gotta have it. You got... Mel? Mel? Mel! Mel!
Is that Mel Gaines on the line?
Oh, no. Nell? Now, listen, honey, I told you never to call me here at the office, okay? Bye, honey.
Look, I told publicity Rex Smith is coming in tomorrow for an interview. Is it set?
Is it set? Is Neil Young? Does Stevie Wonder? Is Rich Little?
Look, it better be.
Oh, yeah.
Or you'll find yourself being the new morning man at our affiliate on Guam.
Goodbye, Mr. Holman. Hello, FCC? Yes, I'd like to report an illegal transmitter. Yeah, it's one of those underground radio stations that seems to be interfering with legitimate broadcasting. It's operating out of Sunset Beach. Sure, I'll hold. Thanks, babe. I got a hunch I'm gonna be seeing you tomorrow.
So you're gonna be playing every Rex Smith song there is on K Fever, like you said?
Hey, you heard it right.
That's great.
I like that song. Everyone tells me if I survive, sooner or later.
I didn't know you couldn't sing.
Ooh, feeling good. Oh.
Come on. Vince Butler, your average, wonderful California kid, right?
Modest. You got to be modest.
Modest. Your average, wonderful, and modest California kid. You know, I'm going to do an interview with a rock star. I mean, just like the big-time disc jockey.
What I like about you, Vince, man, you're so laid back.
You know, Ross, I'm going to tell you a secret I've never told a living soul.
You're wearing a hairpiece, right?
Hey, come on. You know, I wouldn't mind going into radio professionally someday. You know, I figured this Rex Smith thing could give me a real boost.
I bet it would, too.
Yeah, another big one. Yeah. Coming up the charts with Bullets. Those beautiful Bullets.
Man, that hyena, you don't get any better.
I am now making it officially official. You heard it right now. Rex Smith will be here live and in person tomorrow at 4 in the P.M. That's 4 p.m. for all you...
No way, man.
And
there's
by
no...
the way, faithful fans out there in the Sunset Beach area, this is going to be an exclusive interview. Repeat, exclusive interview. So give up the ghost. Know what I mean? And now I'm on my knees with a hyena special. Now!
What a bummer. No, I gotta talk to him. I gotta see him. I gotta reach him. He's at Golden State Recording Studio.
Forget it. Nobody gets in.
Be cool, sir.
Come on, mister. Have a heart.
Do I look like a man with a heart? Out. I don't want to get rough, but if I have
look,
to,
look, we really aren't pesky Rex Smith fans.
You'll do for now. Beat it.
Hey, really, Rex Smith knows me. I set up an interview with him. I'm a disc jockey, and we got our own stage.
And that's the truth.
Yeah. Yeah, show him, Vince. Show him.
Show me what?
home what?
Show them that you're a disc jockey. Do the opening.
Here, I don't have
my mic. Come on, I'll do the sound effects. Okay, now this is how he opens up his show every morning, all right?
Okay.
This is the Ghost of the Coast on the air. Top of the dial is clear as a bell. The underground voice is Sunset. Yeah.
Save it for the gong show. Out.
Oh, come on. Man, I had him going.
Let's go.
What's going on out here, Frank? Rex is recording.
Just a couple of characters trying to crash the session, Mr. Gaines.
Mr. Gaines, are you Rex's manager?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Vince Butler. How you doing?
Mm-hmm.
And this is Ross.
What's happening?
All right. Listen, here's the story. I made a tape, mm-hmm. and Rex listened to it, and he agreed to do an interview with me. Mm-hmm. See, and I set it up with him, so I'm here to, you know.
Now, let me lay some hard facts on you, pal, all right?
Thanks.
Yeah. You don't set up things with Rex. Rex doesn't set up things. Rex. I do. And a 3-watt station's not gonna make it. Look, kid, you don't need a calculator to figure out that 3 watts is not the same as 50,000.
You know, if I could see Rex for a minute, mm-hmm. I think he'd say yes.
I know he would, and that's why you're not gonna be able to see him. I'm sorry, I'm just doing my job. Right? Listen, why don't you leave your name and your address, and I'll make sure that you get Rex's next album free. No problem.
Got it. You got it? Maybe I was playing Saturday. I keep the girls happy.
Man, Rex Smith not coming's really got me in the soup, Al.
Speaking of soup,
what is that?
This is spinach nectar.
Oh, no wonder he's not coming.
And that was the pick of the week on the way to the top. This is the Ghost of the Coast back on the air after minor mechanical. Listen, all my friends out there have been asking me about this Rex Smith interview, and I just wanted to say that I'm hanging in there, and I want you to do the same, but there's some more music coming at you.
Pretty good.
I majored in it in college.
Come on. Really?
Nope, it was law.
Oh, you're a lawyer then?
Not exactly. I'm with the Federal Communications Commission.
The FCC.
You own this place?
Yeah.
The name's Riley. I guess you know what I'm around here for. I have to shut down an underground station all your kids listen to.
Well, I'm not into any of that.
That's too bad. I thought you could give me a lead on it.
And here's the next Rex Smith.
See you later. Listen, son. Ordinarily, we don't bother with little 3-watters like this Coast Ghost has, but somebody from one of the big stations is coming down to my department. They ordered me to find his K fever and shut it down.
Hey, Vince.
Hi, son.
This is Mr. Riley from the FCC.
That's nice, sir.
How you doing?
Rick, let me remind you, it's your duty to assist your government in matters like this. You could find yourself in real trouble, son. You happen to be assisting somebody in an illegal operation.
I understand. Listen, if you'll excuse me, I've got an errand to run, huh? Vince, watch the place, huh?
Yeah.
I'll be back in 10 minutes.
Son, you hear anything, you let me know, right?
Oh, for sure. Sure. I hear anything.
Thank you.
problem, Ross.
What, with your old clunker again?
No, not that old clunker. That old clunker.
Yep. Okay, kid, I'm blowing a whistle on you.
Oh, great, great. You blow the whistle, Rick, you play a little drums, I get a little rhythm guitar, we get a trio happening. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Will you cut out the pretending, son? I know you're the one.
What? What?
Oh, and I led him straight to you, Ross. I'm sorry.
Come on, you might as well show me where it is, son. Don't play dumb.
Who's playing? I am dumb, and I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm Riley from the FCC.
So?
I have to shut you down, son.
Shut me down? Shut me down, that FCC, the underground station. Yeah, yeah. Glad you can make it.
Mr. Riley, go easy on him, huh? I mean, he's a little bit, you know.
Show me the transmitter. I gotta confiscate the equipment. I know it's around here somewhere.
Okay. I'll tell you the truth. Well, it's not here.
I like your honesty, sir.
Thanks.
Now show me where it is.
Okay. You better follow me in your car, though.
Okay. I'll be right behind you.
It's a good idea.
Where do you broadcast from, kid? Tijuana? Hardened criminal anytime.
It all fits together. I mean, the FCC isn't coming after me just out of coincidence, right?
Right.
Right.
Now, Mr. Riley hinted that somebody at K Group was behind it.
One guess who that somebody is.
Hyena Harry. Harry's the one who talked Mr. Gaines into canceling my interview with Rex.
Oh,
strangle him.
He didn't miss a thing, did he?
Well, that won't stop us, right, Vince?
No, wait a second. Before we get too over-optimistic, let's look at the facts, huh, guys? Now, on their side, they have the FCC, Station K Group, Hyena Harry, Mel Gaines, security guards, locks, buttons. And on our side...
Wait! I got a great idea.
What?
We join their side.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah, I've got to go. Okay.
Goodbye.
Can you hurry it up, Phil?
Hurry it up, kid, huh?
Hey, what is that thing up there all about?
Oh, that? Yeah, it's used to track down illegal radio stations, stuff like that. Hey, listen, can you check the tires?
Sure thing.
Well, this is it. It's D-Day. I'm not so sure we can pull this off.
Look, you just get Rex Smith here, huh? Take my word for it. K-Fever will still be on the air when you get back.
Aren't you worried about that FCC man coming back?
Last time I saw him, he looked like a man ready for a vacation. A long
way. Hey, Mr. Goldman, baby, welcome, welcome, welcome. You came in on a Saturday, good.
You noticed, clever boy.
Yeah.
Look, my daughters are coming in later. Is it true? Is Rick Smith coming in this afternoon?
Oh, sure. I just reconfirmed with Mel Gage just a minute ago. It's all set. Don't worry.
Now, that's the truth.
Is it the truth? Is Jackson Brown? Vita Blue? Does the Hollywood Bowl?
We're all packed.
You're all packed.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to go straight from the station to the airport. What's the matter, Rex?
I never heard from Vince Butler.
Oh, Vince Butler, the kid DJ.
Oh, come on, Mel. You didn't have to be so hard on the kid. I mean, we could have done something. A phone interview or something.
You got to stop worrying about that kid.
Really?
He's probably forgotten about the whole thing. For all you know, he's through with broadcasting, and now he's into slot car racing. Hey, what do you want for breakfast? Hey, what do you want for lunch? Hey, we gotta stop.
You know, I'll miss K-Fever. That ghost kid put out some pretty good sounds.
Well, let him put them out in another country. Can't that kid hurry it up?
Did you say 30 in the front, or 32 in the rear, or was it 30 in the... I remember.
Okay, you want some action? I got a plan.
You got a plan?
Absolute beauty.
Okay, what is it? What is it?
Okay, don't rush me. Rex's hotel. We go to Rex's hotel.
Oh, sounds great, Vince. We just kind of slide right in there and invite ourselves to lunch. Stinks.
Yeah, now look who's a downer. I mean, listen, we get to Rex, we bring him down here for the broadcast, the rest is history.
The old suicide mission, good thinking, Vince.
Ross, I know what I'm doing. Hey, Rick, could you turn the big reels over in a couple hours?
Sure.
Great. Laura, you coming?
Oh, wow. I
forgot to put us on the air.
Huh, part of his plan.
Let's go, let's go, we got to fix.
Whoops, here we go. Where is that kid? Hey, kid, let's go. Hey, let's go, huh?
Oh, well, I guess it's okay.
Never mind what you heard on K Group. Marcy, I'm telling you.
That kid's signal's coming from somewhere on a beach. Why aren't we moving? Pimply faced brats have stopped transmitting.
Are you sure we should be here?
Don't break up on me. I know what I'm doing.
around again. The minute we put the station back on the air, he'll be here like a shot.
So we stay off the air, right?
No. We give the guy a run for his money. We load the transmitter on the Grossmobile, send it out on the road, Riley follows, and we lose him.
Right. And be back here with the equipment by 4 o'clock. You got that, Ross?
Oh, I got it. I'm elected to play the fox for the FCC hounds again.
Well, you did it to him once. Now, come on, let's load the Grossmobile.
Right on.
Would you look at this? They're going to lead us to our man. Come along, my dear. Let's not keep Mr. Smith waiting. Come on.
Vince, maybe we better...
No, I know what I'm doing. It's a piece of cake.
Twice? No way.
Hey, come on, Ross. Don't be such a downer. It's time to get back on the air. He's transmitting again. Let's go. Wait. Turn south.
Everybody back, everybody. Rex Smith ain't seeing nobody.
Oh, but I'm his cousin from Nebraska.
Sure. The second one today. You're the reporter from Billboard, and you're his personal manicurist, and you're his guru.
Wait a minute. I'm a disc jockey, and Rex...
Right! You're the disc jockey. Now the roster's complete. Get back! And don't come up again.
Yeah? Lori, you're not gonna believe this, but... sometimes I don't know what I'm doing.
He's going mobile. You know that? The Pepsi's going mobile?
Again, not in a million years.
Come on, let's go.
Signal's getting stronger.
Bill always comes through well.
Woo! I feel like a jerk.
You look adorable.
Come on, get serious. Now you stay here and wish me luck.
Luck.
Thanks.
Tea tray for Mr. Smith?
Right. I'll take that.
I can set it up.
I got it.
There's a... turkey. He's got to sign a check.
You're
going to sign.
Thanks a lot, kid.
I'll take a check.
Quarter.
I don't know how.
Got everything cooking?
All right.
You see him?
Not yet.
He wasn't there?
No, he was there. But I wasn't there.
Wait a minute. Start all over again.
Lori, there's no time. Just trust me. I know what I'm doing. Come on.
I think we're gonna pull this thing off. Think? All we gotta do is keep King Fever on the air for another hour. Vince will find Rex and like...
Two things. One, our van had four-wheel drive. Two, your transmitter gives out a beautiful signal. You let us right back.
And remember, Rex will be here on K-Fever, just like the old ghost promised.
Wrong, kid. K-Fever is off the air now. That's right. First the radio, then the radio station. Then the storage room, I suppose.
Stop right there.
Plan B?
Ready. And remember, don't let him stop you. Roll right on by.
What are you slowing down for?
Uh-oh, he's looking at me funny. Better make this look good.
This isn't smart.
It's like I said before. No search warrant, no search.
Son, cooperate. Well, you gotta make both of our lives a lot easier.
Mr. Riley, he's within his rights. No search warrant, no search.
You know, you're right. You are right. I am gonna call a judge, and I am gonna get a warrant. Could you change that for me, please?
You gotta be kidding.
Anybody got change for a buck?
I never carry that much in cash.
Tap till payday.
You got change for a dollar, young fella?
Yeah, sure.
Hi. Thanks.
Idiot!
What?
Tell me.
What
did you give him change for?
Well, I... Give him my skates.
What did I do?
Andrew, you idiot.
Here.
What do you think I'm doing? Counting pillowcases?
Why'd you leave? You could have gotten in.
I didn't leave. I got carnapped.
Oh, there goes plan B.
Hang loose. Just go on to plan C.
We don't have a plan C.
So what? There's plan K.
K?
Yep, K as in keys.
You forgot about F for firing squad.
Lori, I know what I'm doing.
For the station.
Yeah, okay.
What are you looking for?
The number of that kid that was supposed to interview me. Sorry. Hello, Rick Blaze.
Hello?
I'm trying to get a hold of Vince Butler. Welcome to the club. He's not here. Well, it's about an interview I was supposed to do on his radio station today.
Let me tell you something, pal. There's no interview, no radio station, zilch. It's all over. The FCC's shutting them down. Any message?
Tell him Rex Smith called.
Yeah, right, right.
Rex Smith! Hello, Rex Smith, come back. He hung up. He hung up on me.
Sir, I need you.
Huh?
I need you. There's this gigantic thingy in my bathroom.
A what?
A thingy. This way.
Right. We don't have a plan C.
Be within a second. Mr. Riley, couldn't you let K-Fever stay on the air just a little bit longer?
Sure, until my driver gets back from Judge Gurney with that search warrant.
Mr. Riley, you know what you are? You're stuff, uptight, narrow-minded, stick in the mud. You play lousy pinball.
We go on right after the news, just in time for a few little goodies. Hey, we mustn't forget the little Goldmanettes. How do you like your root beer, honeys? Straight up or on the rocks? Naturally, Rex, you're going to do some of your numbers live, aren't you, pal?
Well, I don't know about that. Mel?
Well, what we're going to do is basically...
Hey, don't worry, Mel, baby. I'm sure we can work something out, huh? Ooh, family portrait, huh?
See you tonight.
All right, bye-bye. Hey, Rex. How you doing?
I'm Vince. Vince Butler.
Vince, where you been? I've been waiting for you, boy.
Hyena Harry here. The guest we had scheduled for this time, what's his name, won't be here because of a previous engagement. I guess... Oh, here's an idea. Our delightful program manager has just stepped into the control booth. Hey, this is going to be a first. Why don't I interview our program director? Tell us, old delightful chief, how long have you been here at K-Groove?
A lot longer than you're going to be, you cackling idiot.
Hey, they're not going to let you go without another song, Rex.
This next tune to the old ghost of the coast himself, the most talented and persistent DJ in the West, Vince Butler.
I can shut him down.
All right, in a minute, we'll get to it.
Thank you.
dispatch.
Now!
Hey!
We only need a room for a little while.
What for?
And whammo, she's gone.
I think I have a way to track her down, guys.
Come out, come out. Stay in, stay in.
My California boyfriend.
Your boss and groovy boyfriend.
More like mellow and laid back, come on.
California fever.
You're getting there.
Temperature rising. Right now, stay tuned for Death Car on the Freeway, next following news break.